how we're going to discuss and review similar figures. So keep in mind, when we're finding missing measures, we have to make sure that figures are similar. So remember, similar figures are the same shape. They have the same or congruent angle. But they are different sizes. So we can make a proportion to find a missing side when shapes are similar. So it tells us ABCD is similar to EFGH. What are two different proportions we can use to find FG? And when we did these originally, we had talked about maybe using highlighters to figure out what sides are marked. And plus, you can look at your letters. AB is first, EF is first. So AB is the proportional side to EF, and so on. We could say that BC, I should have done that in the same color, BC and FG, sorry, this should be orange to match. And then we can say CD and GH, and then you have HE and DA. And you can see that they go in order on the letters. So if we wanted to find FG, which is this side, we can do a proportion a couple different ways. We can do side to side. So we had talked about before, circles on the corresponding sides, squares. So if I can do circle over square, where I have 15 over 45 is equal to, circles here and squares here, where you have the small shape on top and the big shape on the bottom. So then we have 2.5 over something. Or like I had a minute ago, you can do circle over square, where you have the small shape vertical and the big shape vertical. So circle and square on the small shape would be 15 and 2.5. Circle and square on the big shape. So it doesn't matter how you do it, you can see that your cross product is going to be the same. You're still going to say 45 times 2.5 divided by 15. How are they alike? How are they different? So they are alike because it's still going to be 2.5 times 45 divided by 15. They're different in the order that you wrote it. So when you're going to solve it, we're just going to actually do what we wrote here. So we're going to say 45 times 2.5, 25, carry the 2, 22, placeholder, 10, 9, 5, 2, 11. We had one number behind a decimal. So 112.5 divided by 15. Don't forget to bring up your decimal. 15 doesn't go into 1 or 11. 15 goes into 112, 30, 60, 90. 115 is going to be too much, so call it 6. 6 times 5 is 30. 6 plus 3 is 9. 2, don't forget to borrow. 2, and a 5. So then we can say, what do you want to try? We could try, we know it's going to be bigger than 6. Actually, right here, we can see that 22 is bigger than 15, so I actually messed up on this because my amount when I subtract it is bigger than my divisor, so I need to actually take this off, and I need to make that be a 7. 7 times 5 is 35, 7 plus 3, there you go, that's much better. So we're still going to borrow, now we have 75, that works out much better. 5, I forget my decimal here, is going to be exactly 75, so FG is 7.5 centimeters. Now, one of the other ways you could do this, based on our proportion, I'm going to rewrite this one right here. We talked about cross, multiply, divide will work 100% of the time. However, if you look here, there is a scale factor. 15 times 3 is 45, divided 2.5 times 3, I get 7.5 also, which also matches my answer. I don't mind which way you do it. Remember, cross, multiply, divide will work 100% of the time. There's not always a nice scale factor. So here we can do the same thing. Again, find the sides that match. They are similar. So we know that this is where the right angle is. This is our base, so it matches there. We have a shorter side, and then we have a longer side. So if you want, you can use the colors to mark them. Two different proportions. Well, I need to find this piece, so I can still stick with my circles and my squares. Again, we can do circles and squares where we have small shape on top, big shape on bottom. So something is equal to something 6, and then we have 12 and 9, or we can do circles and squares. We get small and big going vertically. So something over 6 and 12 over 9. So remember, it doesn't matter, because if you look, my cross product is going to be the same. So we're still going to say 6 times 12 divided by 9 is going to give us our x. So when we solve this, 6 times 12 is 72. 72 divided by 9 is 8. So JK, line segment JK, is 8 inches long. Do not do the back. We're going to do that after we do the activity in class tomorrow. Let me know if you have any questions on these notes.